Konnichiwa YouTubers, this is Red Stock Straight from Point Magu, California, and today we're going to do a video review of Poppy's GB73 Die Ruger XV and Beast Hunter Go Lion, and that's Megatron. I put them up for a size comparison. As you can see, good old Voltron, Go Lion, what you want to call them, is about 6 inches, 5.5 inches for Die Ruger. Vehicle Voltron if you must. I'll try to use the Japanese saying, so there you go. Let me look at it because these are nice, heavy, solid die-cast pieces. Let's go with everybody's favorite, good old Poppy GB35, made in Taiwan. I'll show you, see if you can read that. I don't know if you can say that, but made in Taiwan. Yes, being a 30-year-old product, it's mostly metal. I'm very surprised. The chest is made is metal. Metal on the legs, metal legs. It's like, wow, there's a very little plastic on that. You can see the plastic painting, and it's rubbed off, but the details are somewhat there. It's beat up. I like the head. It looks real good. Head actually swivels, and that's all you can have. This isn't like the huge GB36, the 11-inch Voltron. I have that. Maybe one day I'll do a review on that thing. Arms do... could have sworn they shot out, but I can't see too much of movement over there. Moves up and down. You got the back panels that do swivel. And just the detail on the chest, the star on his belt. It does have hip rotation, so he can. And a little bit of knee. And I could have sworn there's a swivel there, but not really. So articulation-wise, not the greatest. But, man, he is heavy. So I can't pose them worth, but nonetheless, pretty good looking figure. I like this in this, you won't be able to get these. This is Die Ruger XV Vehicle Voltron, even less articulation. Looks like the head might pop off, but of the two, oh, and this little ears popped off, broke off, and I don't have the little chest piece, so I'm missing a few things. Came with a sword and two extra. It did come with a sword, I think, but the chest piece is definitely missing. I like the detail. It has less die cast than Godot, Go Lion. I forgot the guy's name. From the back, if you want to see. Not much there. But definitely from the front. Definitely display pieces. It looks like the lion's tails were supposed to move. Oh, well. It does not come apart, though. It's definitely a display piece. All right. Die Ruger. If y'all remember, I did a review of that big, humongous 15-inch model. It came with it came in three components: sea, air, and land. So, this is my favorite of the two. It looks flashier. The knee bends a little bit, but that's all you're going to get. Now, I broke this arm. Had to super glue that thing on, so I'm not going to move it. And this basically moves up and down. So. Other two, I know he's a shorter, but you gotta love someone with roller skates. Definitely 70s or 80s. Where else will you get yellow and brown as a color, a viable color option? Seriously, just smack dab. And I like the crystal display on the shins or whatever the heck that is. Yeah. Not much else, but I don't know. It's just stylish. It's something that you don't see very often anymore. GB35 and GB35 and GB73, Die Ruger XV15, Beast Hunter Go Lion, Voltron, and Vehicle Voltron, whatever you want to call them. I like these figures. If you can get them for cheap, they're not, they're collector's item. I'm not going to rate them because they're basically bricks. It's just a sense of nostalgia that I wanted to show y'all and I wanted to give you. And again, just for size comparison. Megatron! Alright, YouTubers, it's all I got, and I catch y'all next time.